Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Lupiani. My student's number is 19212042. And today I will show you how to teach grammar using the grammar translation method or GTM. GTM is the oldest method of teaching. The grammar translation method is a foreign language teaching method derived from the classical or sometimes called traditional method of teaching Greek and Latin. This method has been used from the classical times to translate classical languages, Latin and Greek. According to Brown 2008, grammar translation method is a method which focuses on the grammatical rules, memorization of vocabulary and of various declination and conjugation, translation of text and doing written exercise. And according to Peter and Sells Muria, 1979, in Brown, 2007, there are characteristics of grammar translation method. First, classes are taught in the mother tongue with little active use of target language. Second, much of vocabulary is taught in the form of lists of isolated words. Third, long, elaborate explanations of the intricacies of grammar are given. Fourth, grammar provides the rules of putting words together, and instruction often focuses on the form and inflection of words. Next, reading of difficult classical texts is begun early. Next, little attention is paid to the content of texts which are treated as exercises in grammatical analysis. Next, often the only drills are exercises in translating disconnected sentences from the target language into the mother tongue. And the last is little or no attention is given to pronunciation.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning, student. How are you?
Good morning. I'm fine, thanks. And you?
I'm good, thanks. So, today we will learn about simple past tense. Do you know about simple past tense?
No.
Okay, simple past tense adalah kalimat yang digunakan untuk menunjukkan masa lalu atau kejadian yang sudah terjadi. Misalnya, kejadian yang terjadi pada kemarin atau yesterday. Lalu last week atau minggu lalu. Atau last year.
Tahun lalu.
Lalu 2 days ago.
Dua jam yang lalu.
Ya, last night.
Tadi malam.
Nah, rumusnya adalah subjek, verb 2, dan objek. Jadi, simple past tense ini menggunakan verb 2. Nah, dalam verb itu terdapat regular verbs dan irregular verbs. Regular verbs itu atau bisa disebut dengan kata kerja yang beraturan. Ujungnya itu seperti ed dan d. For example, play menjadi played. Enjoy menjadi enjoyed. Lalu, irregular verbs. Irregular verbs itu bisa juga disebut dengan kata kerja tidak beraturan. Jadi, verb 1 dengan verb 2 itu tidak menggunakan ed dan verb 2-nya. Tetapi, ada kata tersendiri seperti, for example, go menjadi went, eat menjadi ate, dan run menjadi ran. Langsung ke contohnya ya. Contohnya, awalnya, kalimatnya seperti ini. He plays basketball. Ini kan menunjukkan pada waktu yang sedang terjadi ya. Nah, kalau bermain basketballnya pada minggu lalu, maka plays-nya itu berubah menjadi played atau menjadi verb 2. Jadi, he played basketball last week. Ini merupakan contoh dari regular verbs. Nah, ikuti ya. He plays basketball.
He plays basketball.
Jadi, dia
bermain bola basket.
Ya, good job. Lalu he played basketball last week.
Dia bermain bola basket minggu lalu.
Ya, lalu contoh kedua dalam irregular verbs atau kata kerja yang tidak beraturan. Misalkan, paham ya?
Paham.
Nah, sekarang karena sudah paham, saya akan memberikan task atau tugas. I will give you a task tentang simple past tense. Silakan kerjakan.
That's all from me about grammar translation method. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.